If I were SpongeBob SquarePants, this would be my antenna. Krabby Patties! Krabby Patties! Oh, got him! Sorry, Alex. I had to go there. Today, we're taking a look at the shapeshifter antenna. Shapeshifter. Vroom. Vroom. Ha ha ha, shapeshifter. Or a mask for your next masquerade party. Ha ha! I'm not sure, but we'll talk about it in a second. Now, the idea behind Alex Greaves, Video Aerial Systems, IB Crazy, antenna, see, he gets like three names, like long ones too, that must mean he's important, or really, really smart. Where was I? I got sidetracked, sorry. The idea behind this antenna, which this one is for the 900 milliwatt hertz, megahertz thing. Let me see what it says. Does it say that for 900 megawatts? Hang on, I think it's megawatts. Hang on a second. Ah, megahertz. You're welcome. The idea behind this, it is an omni. If you take this little switch here and keep it to the left, it is like an extreme panel antenna. If you shift this to the right, like a laser beam. I can't show you right now because then all the military people will be asking me questions and stuff, and then I'd have to turn in Alex for making wacky alien equipment. In omni mode, this is 2.25 dBi. In crazy laser focused forward mode, where all this stuff comes in from here and goes out to there, it is 7.25 dBi. Once you have switched it into Godzilla mode, throwing flames out the side of it and stuff, it is a 90 degree angle of transmission or reception or King Kong eating his bananas. I don't know. I don't have to know these things technically. Alex does. So, you know, he's smart and I'm just a pretty one. I mean, come on, if I worked on it, I could have been Vanna White. Shut up. Now I'm gonna go ahead and steal a couple pictures off Alex's website, VAS Systems. I'll put the link here or something. It's, I don't know what the whole, I think it's videoaerialsystems.com or something. I don't, he wants you to break your fingers while you're typing it because you should suffer a little bit for his equipment. This, again, is the Crossfire type device or FRI Sky R9 device that you use in the 900 milliwatt area of the spectrum of all these crazy radio waves that you can't see. Kind of like a deer whistle. I never heard anything, and I doubt the deer did too, but I believe this, because secret invisible waves, contrails. The Earth is a flat disc. Ha, choke on it. I tried this out, and I liked it very much. There was a really good demonstration by Popo. That's why I'm not gonna go to my video. My friend Popo put this on, and he said, whoa. And I said, what? He goes, wait. And I said, all right. 4 days later, he got over his shock. If you choose, we'll get to Popo in a second. If you choose to use this, remember, when you hold your transmitter, sometimes we hold this down like this. Don't do that. Well, okay, yes you can, but you just bend this back up like that. And you have full effect from this antenna out to whatever the heck it is you're flying. Because if you keep it down like this, it's not gonna work. Don't do it like this. You're welcome. I gave it to Popo. We put it on his little doohickey thing. He had some that FR Sky, like game controller type transmitter. Wacky, you know, I'm old school. I need to have the big ones in my hand. That's right, that applies to everything. Let's talk to Popo a minute and see what he thinks. Popo just took out the shapeshifter for Crossfire. Not bad, huh?
No. There's a section, so I flew out.
Out by where the flag is.
Out by the flag and farther out.
Right.
And with my regular Crossfire antenna on the radio,
uh-huh.
I was getting...
The antenna, down, yeah.
The antenna. On the null spots, I was getting like 80, 70 sometimes.
Yeah.
But with this antenna...
We went all the way out, and you can see the video here. Yeah, and you were still holding 99.
99.
And then we actually flew it behind you. And got unexpected results too. So.
Flew it behind me on flipping it to long range.
Right.
And it should have been forward. The radio's behind my body and I'm flying behind me. and I was still getting 99.
Yeah, and I think the only time you got 97 was when we dipped into the trees, right?
Yes.
Okay. That's not bad. So there you go. The shapeshifter, I'll say that right this time, the shapeshifter works.
Yes, sir.
The hype is real.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, believe the hype.
During part of his flight, because Popo knows like I know, those immortal T antennas from Team Black Sheep, TBS, have null points. Why? I don't know. I don't even know what a null is. But it has them. In this part of the video, when you fly parallel with yourself, if you can actually do that, I'm not sure, but you try it and let me know. When you fly parallel with yourself, the end of the TBS Immortal antennas hits a null spot, which means reception is at its lowest or none at all.
So we're trying out.
I'm not ready.
You're not?
No, I gotta get this.
Do what to what?
Let me tune in.
Oh, you're tuning it?
All
right, this review is now delayed because of Elliot.
I also had the 2.4 version of this, which I gave to Elliot. Elliot enjoyed it so much, he took it home with him right after we got done. I've never seen him again. Thanks.
Now Elliot's ready, prima donna.
I am prepared. So
we've got an XM Plus on here?
Yes, we do.
2.4, we put the antenna on. And you went internal first, and how'd you do?
Internal? Not that great.
Yeah.
You know, we had decent range, but it started to drop off as we got further away. I'd say maybe 100 yards were starting to go down pretty quickly.
Okay. Then we put this in place. You turned it onto external.
Right.
And we first had it on
the
Omni, and we picked up, what, about 10?
It was probably 8 and 10 dBi high.
Yeah. Okay.
But it fluctuated
right
pretty heavily.
Yeah.
Now when we switched over to long range, it was night and day.
Yeah. You know, it was lightning bolt.
Lightning bolt, pretty much solid the whole time.
Boom. You can say boom. Say boom. Boom. There you go. Boom.
It was ridiculous. So,
right.
Fantastic.
So, happy with it. You'll use it a lot.
I'll probably use it every single day.
All right. Congratulations.
Thank you, sir.
You're welcome.
Cheers.
That was the girl handshake.
It was. Because
we're like little girls anyway. So there you go.
That is one happy camper. Seriously, look at his face. Look at his eyes glowing. He's like, whoa, I didn't know I could get that. Well, yes, you can. Right after that interview with Elliot, he said, hey, send me that link. I need to get two more. You can ask him. He'll be in the comments. You'll see. He actually got two more because he enjoyed that. We flew that on his little tiny whoop. It wasn't little, it was an 85 millimeter tiny with Beta FPV, but it had FR Sky XM Plus on it, and it worked out quite well. As you can see, you know, that's what he said, wasn't it? Well, now that I have amazed you with all these acronyms that even I don't pretend to understand because, I don't know, you throw a couple letters together and all of a sudden it's something, isn't it? You might want to think about getting this for your transmitter, whether it be the 2.4 version or this 900 megahertz version. You want to look into this because two guys can't be that wrong, can they? No. And then you make it three for me? Ha! That's three people who said, wow, that's pretty good. Fighting the Harbor in the Beetle City of Tampa, Florida! Clear!